Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Dinesh. I am working as an Ayurvedic consultant in Sri Sri Datta Panchakarma. Today we will be talking about allergies. So before going into allergies, first we will see what is a normal condition. So if someone will go, suppose I will go to a place which is having dust, pollution, things like that, I will start sneezing. So I will sneeze for around 5 to 10 seconds. That is basically if some outside particles will go inside my system, the body will start producing something called a antibodies, which is against the particles which enter inside my system. So that is the reason behind that we will cough, we will sneeze, things like that. But if the person with allergy, if he will go to the same environment, he will start sneezing or coughing for say more than 10 minutes. The reason behind it is like the same allergens, which is the foreign particles, will enter inside the system and body will start creating antibodies, which is more than usual. So that is the reason that person will sneeze or cough more than usual. So this is what allergy means, the hyperimmunity. The body start reacting more than usual towards a particular allergen or a foreign particle is called allergy. So the next question will be like, only coughing and sneezing will happen? No. The allergens can affect any part of our body. It can affect our respiratory system, which will create something called asthma, running nose, sinusitis, things like that. If it will affect our stomach, it will cause food allergies. If it will affect our skin, it will create skin allergies. If it will affect our eyes, it will create allergic conjunctivitis. Like that, many things will happen inside the system because of these reasons. So, first we will go to the respiratory allergies, basically, which is the common thing. So, if the allergies will happen to the respiratory system, most commonly seen is asthma. I think most of you must have heard about the condition called asthma. Basically, it is a breathing difficulty. So in asthma, what will happen is like, suppose we are drinking the lemon juice with a straw. So in between, the lemon seed came. So what will happen? The flow of that water will be less than before. The same thing will happen. Whenever the body is exposed to allergens, see, allergens will be the foreign particles. So our lungs will get inflamed. And whenever the inflammation will happen, the body will produce mucus, that is like a phlegm, basically, to soothe this inflammation. So the both will create a obstruction to the lungs. So that is called asthma. So that is the reason why if a normal person will need only one inhalation to fill his lungs, the person who is suffering with asthma, who needs two inhalations, that two deep inhalations to fill his lungs. But this is the normal concept. In Ayurvedic point of view, we are having some other concept called an ama like that. So in Ayurveda, we are having a concept that we are having an agni, basically the digestive fire, and all diseases will happen because of the imbalance in that agni. So whenever the person who is allergic or who is asthmatic, whenever he or she, they are having the food which is difficult to digest, it'll go to the digestive system, it won't get digested very completely. So it will cause something called an ama, which is a undigested food particle. So once the ama is formed, body will start creating more amount of a mucus in the system, which will get absorbed to the blood and it will go to the lungs and will accumulate there. So this is the reason the person is suffering from asthma according to the concept of Ayurveda. And this is the common reason why we can see if one person is affected with asthma, if he is having the food which is difficult to digest, the next day, he will suffer with asthma because of this reason. In Most of the times, what people will do is like they will go to a allopathic doctor. He will give something called bronchodilators, like a Derifilin, things like that, or else he will give an inhaler. So in this, what will happen is, instead, as I said before, the straw and seed of lemon concept. Instead of removing the seed, they will expand the straw. So automatically we will feel better. But it is just for a period of time. Once its effect is over, it will go back to the stage one. But in Ayurveda, we are having a different concept. First, we will do the bronchodilation. Bronchodilation means we will remove the seed from the straw itself. That is the first thing. Second thing, we will give some of the medicine for expectoration, basically to remove the excess of the phlegm from the system. And third, we'll give something called an immunomodulator. Immunomodulator is basically means to improve the immunity as well as the capacity of the lungs, which is not so common in allopathic practices. So this is what we will do in Ayurvedic system. Then we are having something called a skin allergies also is there. Skin allergy is a very complicated one because it will not only affect one person physically, it will affect the person mentally as well as socially. Because whenever the skin is not so good, you will feel a bit of dullness as well as you will feel a bit depressed. You are not that much confident about yourself. Self-confidence won't be there. So because of that reason, you will try to avoid socializing as well. So that is the reason I said skin issues will create all these problems. And the causes can be also different. It will start from sun to anything below the sun as well. Basically, sun means some of the people who are allergic to sunlight also. And anything below the sun means it may be a pollen, it may be a foreign metal, it may be your artificial jewelry, sometimes something made up of nickel, many things will be there. So this will all start irritating the skin and will create the redness, itchiness, and distortion of the skin. Many things will happen. But in Ayurveda, we are having an entirely different concept, which is called Rakta Dushana. Rakta Dushana means impurity of the blood. In Ayurveda, we are having a concept called a Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. In this, Pitta is the one which will vitiate the or make the blood impure, and it will create problems in the skin. And it will also cause because of other doshas as well. See, if the blood is get impured with Vata, it will create more amount of a dryness. If it is affected with Pitta, this oozing, things like that will happen. So like that, because of one doshas, one's own things will happen. In Ayurveda, we are having a concept called a detoxification, which is a very good option in this. And along with that, we are having something called a Rakta Mokshana. That is basically to purify the blood itself. So we are having that instead of going to something called as steroids or as antihistamines. This all will give a very temporary relief. That's it. But Ayurveda is having a very good effect on all these conditions. Next is basically sinusitis. I think most of you must have heard about these things. Sinusitis is a condition where our sinus will get inflamed. That may be because of any external factors. Because of that reason, the sinus, the mucus inside that won't come out and it will get infected and will create blockage of the nose, headaches, then fever. These all will create because of that reason. So the sinusitis is also because of allergies. So for that, we'll call like the allergic sinusitis like that. Then other allergy that we will see most of the time is like, most of the guests will tell, doctor, whenever I am getting up from the bed, I will sneeze for first 10 minutes, then I will be perfectly fine. The reason behind this is the mites, which is present in your pillows as well as your bed sheets. It will mostly happen from the dead skin of your scalp, your skin, as well as along with sweat. So this is the other reason behind the sneezing in the morning time. Along with that, many other reasons are there. It is not the only reason, but 80% of the allergies will happen because of this reason. Next is food allergies. Food allergies is also very common, but it is very problematic as well as for treating also it is very difficult because it can be anything. So most of the times it will be any protein like peanuts, cashew nuts, things like that. But I had one of the guests who are having the allergy towards the hing, asafoetida as well. So it is a very complicated thing which need a good power to analyze what all we had, what all we didn't had, when it happened. So these all are important whenever it is related to food allergies. But again, Ayurveda is having a very good success rate to treating the food allergies as well. So this coming 26th, we are having a webinar which is on asthma. In this, we are telling you about what all are the reasons for asthma, when to treat asthma, what are the causes of asthma in kids, as well as some of the home remedies, some of the things that you can do at home itself, like small Ayurvedic treatments, things like that you can do at home itself, which will give a very good impact than using an inhaler. Very instantaneous it will give. And along with that, some yogas, mudras, these things also we are teaching on that day. And on 27th, we are having a webinar on rest of the allergies, basically the skin, then allergic rhinitis, sinusitis, food allergy, things like that. In this, we will tell you how we can maintain all those things, as well as instead of going for a steroid for a longer period of time, how you can get rid of it, like you can maintain, balance it, as well as to cure these conditions. So I welcome you all for both of the webinar, because there will be some common things that we will be telling about telling in both the webinars. Because see, in for an example, we will tell about the dhumapana. Basically, it is a very good option to reduce the excess of phlegm in the system. That we will be explaining in the webinar in the asthma. But the same thing will be good for the sinusitis as well. So we won't tell that in the webinar, which is in the sinusitis part. So I request all of you to attend both the webinar on the coming 26th and 27th. Thank you.